In this view, we will be demonstrating the lateral skull. The lateral skull should be performed with the patient standing or sitting at the upright bucky or lying on the table. With a 40-inch source to image distance and no tube angulation. For lateral projections of the skull, it is recommended that right and left is done. I have my patient standing at the upright bucky with the left side of his head closest to the IR. This places the mid-sagittal plane parallel to the IR. The IOML is perpendicular to the front edge of the IR. I have no angle on the x-ray tube. I am at 40 inches distance. The interpupillary line is perpendicular to the IR. The central ray is 2 inches superior to the EAM, the external auditory meatus. The collimation is a half an inch to an inch around the shadow of his skull, making sure you have the vertex of his head included. Patient will hold very still and the exposure is made. A diagnostic lateral skull radiograph must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include superimposed orbital roofs and the greater wings of the sphenoid. The cella turcica in profile with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating a PA skull. The PA skull should be performed with the patient standing or sitting at the upright bucky or lying prone on the table with a 40-inch source to image distance and no tube angulation. For the PA view of the skull, I have my patient standing at the upright bucky tray. It can also be done on the tabletop, and it can also be done with the patient sitting at a chair. So my patient is upright and I have placed his nose and his forehead against the IR. The mid-sagittal plane is perpendicular to the IR. I have made sure that his external auditory meatus, which is known as the EAM, is equal distance from the bucky so that there is no rotation. The central ray exits out through the nasion, and I have collimated a half an inch to an inch around the shadow of his skull. I have placed a right marker on the right side and he is shielded. The patient will hold very still and the exposure is taken. A diagnostic PA skull radiograph must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include symmetric petrous ridges, orbits filled by petrous ridges, with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the AP axial skull Towns view. The AP axial skull Towns view should be performed with the patient standing or sitting at the upright bucky or lying supine on the table with a 40-inch source to image distance and a 30-degree caudate angulation. For the AP axial view of the skull, I have my patient sitting at a chair because I have a substantial angle. I've still set it at 40 SID. I have a 30-degree angle because my patient is able to lower his chin. When he lowers his chin, I am going to use the OML, which is the orbital meatal line. The patient is not as flexible, then we're going to use a 37-degree caudate angle, and we'll use the IOML, which is the infraorbital meatal line. We want to make sure that he's lined up well with the mid-sagittal plane. The mid-sagittal plane actually forms a perpendicular plane to the IR. The central ray is 2.5 inches above the glabella when he lowers his chin. Our collimation is a half an inch to an inch around the shadow of the skull, making sure that you have the superior vertex in the shadow. The patient has a right marker here. He's going to hold really still and the exposure is taken. A diagnostic AP axial skull Towns view radiograph must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include symmetric petrous pyramids, dorsum cella, and posterior clinoid processes visible within foramen magnum with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail. In this view, we will be demonstrating the PA axial skull, Caldwell view. The PA axial skull, Caldwell view, should be performed with the patient standing or sitting in the upright bucky or lying prone on the table with a 40-inch source to image distance and a 15-degree cotted tube angulation. For the PA axial view, I have my patient standing at the upright bucky. I have a 15-degree cotted angle on the central ray. The mid-sagittal plane is aligned to the board and it actually forms a perpendicular plane to the IR. My patient's nose and forehead is rested up against the board. The central ray exits out through the nasion. I have a half an inch to an inch collimation around the shadow of his skull. I have placed a right marker on the right side. I've also made sure that there was no rotation of the skull by making sure that the external auditory meatus, the EAMs, are of equal distance from the board. The patient will hold very still and the exposure is made. A diagnostic PA axial skull, Caldwell view, radiograph must be free of motion and rotation. Demonstrated anatomy to include symmetric petrous ridges, petrous pyramids lying in the lower third of the orbit, with proper visualization of soft tissue and bony detail.
If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.